If the weather outside is frightful, just hit Control-Alt-Delete. Hey guys, it's Jonathan Strickland with Forward Thinking, and holy cow, is it cold. It's 10 degrees Fahrenheit here in Atlanta today. This is a city where we don't like to see ice unless it's in our tea. And it got me to thinking, when is someone finally going to fulfill the ambitions of Cobra Commander and build a working weather control device? Here's the hard part. Weather systems are full of energy. NASA estimates that your average hurricane during its lifespan expends the equivalent energy of 10,000 nuclear bombs. With a system that complex and that energetic, we have trouble predicting it, much less controlling it. But that doesn't mean we haven't tried other ways to manipulate the weather. Take cloud seeding, for example. Now, this is a method we've been using for decades to try and make it rain. And the idea is pretty simple. You've got a cloud full of moisture. So then you introduce millions of tiny particles so that water droplets can glom onto them and grow until they're heavy enough to fall as rain or snow. So, does it work? Maybe. Here's the hard part. We can't really be sure when it rains, if it rained because we seeded the cloud, or if it was just gonna rain anyway. But that hasn't stopped countries like China from putting hundreds of millions of dollars into research. In fact, they say that the reason we had such a sunny opening ceremony at the Beijing Olympics is because farmers in the surrounding area had been seeding the clouds and draining them of moisture so they wouldn't hit the city. Jury's still out on that one. Meanwhile, some scientists are suggesting some pretty extreme ways to affect the weather, including beaming microwaves either from the ground or from space in order to dismantle a tornado or steer a hurricane. But here's the thing. We don't know for sure that either of these methods would actually work, and the law of unintended consequences suggests that there's a possibility we could make things worse rather than make them better. There's also an ethical question. If you can steer a hurricane and deflect it from one area, what happens if it hits a different populated area? I would be shocked if we see weather control technology come into existence before I shuffle off this mortal coil, but what wouldn't surprise me is to see better and better prediction models, because organizations like the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration have some of the world's most powerful supercomputers running on thousands of processor cores and using some of the most sophisticated algorithms in existence to predict weather. So every year, we're getting better and better at predicting weather. So maybe we are never able to stop a polar vortex from turning me into an icicle, but we might be able to warn me early enough so I can prepare for it. So I've got a question for all of you out there. What piece of science fiction gadgetry that doesn't exist yet do you want in your possession? And tell us why. Maybe you want a replicator so you can have a burger whenever you like. Let us know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit like and subscribe to our channel, and then check these videos out over here. Meanwhile, I'm gonna go find a way to thaw out.